of the film that was in his camera and what he could set it at without using a light meter. The cameras were he was always looking to create something out of the situation.
Cool. You see?
He was an artist. He loved to paint, he loved to draw. Cameras were a big passion of his.
Hello. Yeah. We're gonna go on a mission right now. So will you come with me?
Oh, you will.
Austin filmed what we're doing. He was like creating something straight away. He always used to say to me, feet. We'd watch a lot of our videos back. It's just.
That's right. Evil supervillain. Who? Got it, boss. Let's go. Okay, I've got my mission. Not the peephole. You never know who's out there waiting.
Yeah, and that's why I wanted to be a part of it. It was, biopics can be, incredibly defaming to the person they're trying to, create a portrait of, and presenting some flesh and blood for him to kind of say the dialogue and be the character that he created. But Todd certainly gave us a lot of freedom and space, but he had a very set vision, which I think he and no one else owned.
Sure, welcome to the city, you. Welcome to the United States. You're from Australia, is that right?
Yeah, that's right.
Where in Australia?
I grew up in Perth, Western Australia.
Mm-hmm. Yeah. Oh, that's as far on, that's on the West Coast.
Yeah, it's the most isolated city in the world, yeah. Actually.
What was it, as a kid, it must be great, I guess, if we were a kid, huh?
Yeah, it was fun, I had a strange upbringing, I guess, I don't know, I grew up, my dad's spent like 30 years in the racing industry, so I
really?
Grew up
what did he do?
Of Western Australia.
For like the community of the town and stuff?
Yeah, we did.
Huh? Yeah. And people don't mind that? The city doesn't mind that?
No, they love it. They love it.
Were you injured in the making of the film?
Yeah, I was actually, funnily enough. I got like 3 stitches in my little finger here.
Oh my God.
That moment was a very important next step. Okay, what do we want to do next? What do we really want to do if we have a choice?
That's how he learned. He never studied anything, really. He was self-taught. He could really see what he was doing and how to do that better or different. Even if it was the way he smiled or where he was looking, he'd make a lot of things just for himself, just to teach himself.
Heath called me and said,
so this is first day. Shooting. It's the first day on the Patriot for me. I'm looking forward to it. It's been 3 months since I found out I got this job, and finally, after 3 months of sitting around thinking about it, I get to go out there and do it. This is it. So, blink my eyes and we'll be out there.
You could tell that he wanted to do a good job. He was still learning. Took me to all these auditions, all these interviews. Never asked. He just money. As a 17-year-old, it was impressive. Wow. Here we are.
I'm reading this. Bruce Lee's The Tao of Kung Fu, and it's really interesting. If you want to go somewhere on your bike, you can't push on both pedals. You know, you got to push and pull in life in all areas. It's interesting.
I never moved there expecting anything to happen. Kind of went there with the attitude of,
Lisa. I gave him my friend's script, 10 Things I Hate About You. He read the script and said, I really like the role of Patrick. He said, yes, Patrick's the lead, and that's the part I want.
Sometimes people break through because of one thing, whether it's good looks or talent.
I've thrown a football away a few times in my life. So.
And their physicality aids.
There was a bunch of kids staying in a hotel. 10 Things was when he really felt that, okay, this is my career. I'm an actor now. But then he had his agent, Steve.
So how long have you been acting?
About 20 years.
How old are you?
I'm 20.
Okay, he's not there. Let's keep on looking. Down here. Lord, it was an effort. Thank God I made it.
He definitely learned how to relax a little rather than building himself up of like with Mel on his jet cruising back to LA. So we were always going on adventures and looking for the next adventure that was exciting and fun.
It's hard to be as solid as he was.
He was mortified, and he felt owned.
His image, not their image.
Fearless in how he looked.
He had this light around him wherever he went.
We are lucky that he completed so much in his life.
He was having a hard time, and he was struggling, just a crisis of confidence. He would get caught up in the fear of whether or not he could accomplish what he wanted to do. He kind of almost pulled out of every movie he ever ended up doing.
Heath and I had mutual friends, so it was a setup. We met, and
he was seeing the world in a way that the rest of us didn't, and in a way that the rest of us couldn't.
I think in life, in general, you know, I mean, it's one thing to be romantic in love, but I think romance
It's a universal thing in terms of, you know, in life. I think it's important to be romantic. I did, but I never moved there expecting anything to happen, or, you know, I kind of went there with the attitude of, well, I've got nothing to lose.
Spying in on you, it actually feels like you're getting a slap across the face.
Right, right.
And we can't physically stand up and hit them back, of course. Right. It would be rude and against the law.
Right, right.
So you get an egg and...
That's a good idea. Do you carry eggs with you? Do you have an egg dispenser?
Yeah.
Do you have a carcass?
Those folk tales and, you know, actually, in actual fact, Jacob, my character, went on to become a politician.
Mm-hmm.
They wrote half the German dictionary, la-da-da-da. And then there's our film. And our film's, I don't know if you've seen it or not, but it's a Terry Gilliam version of this, so it's a fairy tale.
Keeping in the kind of generalization on his attention to detail is microscopic, but it's more or less in the way he observes life and his ability to kind of translate what he sees to you. I don't think I would have accepted the role if it was just any actor. It had to be, obviously a good actor.
This is disgusting.
Oh. Well, I don't know. I think it's a real shame. I think it's immature, for one, really immature. But I think it's an incredible shame that people go out of their way to discuss or to voice their disgust, I should say, or negative opinions about the way two people wish to love one another. I mean, come on. I mean, at least voice your opinions on how two people show hate and violence and anger towards each other. Isn't that more important? I think so. So I don't know, and it doesn't really concern me. I think it's a shame, but I also feel like it'll surprise people. It's not particularly a story. I mean, it's obviously about two men in love, and it's obviously gay themed, and it's very easily labeled. But unfortunately, people are very quick in life to label something that they're uncomfortable with. The pure fact of it is it transcends a label. It's human. It's a story of two human beings, two souls that are in love. It's like, get over the fact that there's two men. That's the point. The movie is not a story about an epidemic or a virus or something that can be cured in hospital. We're showing that love between two men is just as infectious and emotional and strong and pure as it is with heterosexual love. And if you can't understand that, then just don't go see the movie. It's okay. You know, we don't care. It's like, deal with it in your own private life. Don't voice it out, you know? It's like, we don't want to know, and it's really boring and old and whatever, you know? But we're very proud of it, and I think it's transcended that, you know? And so,